I was born by the banks of the Tahi. My dad passed away when I was very young. And his brother took up the responsibility of looking after me. It's about 10 different language groups living here. Different clans, 10 different clans living here. I'm of the Ngangumeri clan. The people that are recognised as traditional owners of this land, the Malak Malak people. Our elders went and got a church in Darwin to say, come and work amongst us. But we had a history about 130 years ago. The Jesuits were here, the missionaries, they've given us the responsibilities to look after this place. One day, my mum got violently ill, and she's sick for nearly a month. I was about 10 then. She was in the x-ray room having scans or x-rays done to her, and she just collapsed and died. In our customs or in our traditions, I couldn't stay with my dad. It was not an accepted thing. So somehow he organized for a priest to come from here, for him to come and get me, to bring me back here. And the priest said, take her back and the nuns can look after her. When I was 12, I got christened. 8th of December, I made my first communion. I had to do some catch-up work with in wanting to know what I wanted to be in life. You know, I started off working as an assistant teacher here in this school, St. Francis Xavier's. Became a teacher. I ended up becoming a principal for 13 years here. I did some of my studies at bachelor, and I ended up getting about 7 or 8 of us go off and train to become teachers. When you become a teacher, you're not just a teacher for the kids at the school, you're also a teacher for the whole community. We studied with Deakin University in Victoria, Greece, Bachelor of Education, Arts and Education, my Master's, and I've got a honorary doctorate from the uni in Darwin, Charles Darwin. But I'm retired now and I wouldn't run away from everybody. Like my friends always say, I'm the most wanted person dead or alive. The kids are always saying, when's your holiday gonna finish? When are you coming back? You know, like, well, what are we, 60,000 years old? Our race? We had to be in rhythm with the land to be able to survive. We had to understand the seasons. You know, going to the billabong and looking at the flowers and see how beautiful they are. You walk up on the hill looking for things to eat, you know, like the yam or the echidna or whatever. There's hardly any water up there. And you see flowers growing there. How does that flower survive? You know, with just the dew in the morning? And there's got to be somebody that looks after, looks out for these things. So there's a spirit that's greater than us here, amongst us. This painting here that I've got in front of me is called The Living Water. That's the river. And it's fed by the spring. The river's famous for barramundi fishing. And it's also the billabongs and the waterholes around here that's fed by the river. It's full of turtles and water lilies that we collect. Like when these lily seeds come out, it's during Easter. It's like when Christ dies at Easter. The water floods the billabongs, and then when the water recedes, the beautiful blue lily, water lilies come out. And for me, I think of Christ rising from the dead, and then he leaves us himself in the form of bread. And so the water lily seeds that come from the beautiful blue water lily flowers, the petals fall off, and then there's a bulb that we collect and we eat the seeds from, and it nourishes us. I think it's to do with praying. I pray better when I'm doing something like this. My painting, you know, I use that as prayer.